What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to increase your tick speed in Minecraft. Ticks are a measurement of time in-game. This means that it's responsible for making mobs spawn, trees grow, entity movements, and more, so you are going to want to keep this in mind when altering its values, since it does play a critical role in your server and world. The default tick speed for Java is 3, while Bedrock runs on 1, so make sure to remember these numbers if you're planning on ever changing them back to normal. Before changing the tick speed of your Minecraft world, regardless of the edition you're using, you're going to need to have to enable cheats or become a server operator. Then, once you are starting to edit them, you're going to also want to make sure you keep the values reasonable. You shouldn't set it to super large numbers because it will wreck your game, so try slowly increasing it until you find something that works best for you. Java's single player makes it really easy for you to change the tick speed, but only if you already have cheats enabled. If you don't, you can open your world to LAN so you can enable cheating, or you can directly edit your world files with NBT Editor, though this is harder to do. Open Minecraft and head towards your desired world from the main menu and make sure cheats are enabled. And then once you're in game, you can type /game rule random tick speed and then the value in the chat. And then you can just continue to do this until you find a value you're happy with. For a multiplayer server, you're going to want to head towards your Apex server panel and become a server operator if you're not one already. And then you can either join the server and run the same game rule random tick speed value command in chat, and do this until you're satisfied with the result. Unlike Java Edition, Bedrock allows you to quickly activate cheats in a single player world without too much work, but with a server, you're still going to have to use the panel. Launch Minecraft and enter the world, and then make sure Activate Cheats is enabled in the Bedrock settings, and afterwards find and change the random tick speed value to anything you want, or you can use that same exact game rule command in the chat. And once again for servers, head towards your panel and click Config Files near the top left. Click on Bedrock Server Settings and then set Allow Cheats to Enabled. Press the Save button at the bottom and then restart the server. Become a server operator, join the world, and enter that game rule random tick speed value command in chat. As for what this is actually going to change in your world, tick speeds can help players' crops grow faster, make mobs appear faster, and more. This is primarily used for farming since it can be a while for crops to be harvestable. After changing the value, depending on the value that you choose, you should see your crops immediately start to grow. Now, before we get into the common issues, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all of our future videos. If you change the tick speed value in Minecraft and then your server keeps crashing, it means you set it too high or you have too many events happening in-game. Because the server keeps crashing, it is going to be a bit tedious to fix, but the first method is to restore from a backup, which you can do in the panel, or you can manually edit the tick speed from the NBT editor after downloading the world, and then uploading it back with the new changes. If after increasing the tick speed value on your world it starts to lag, then decrease the value. Limiting events and activities in the world can also help. For example, disabling redstone machines, reducing render distances, or removing some farms are just a few ways to fix the problem. Other than that, increasing tick speed is a great way to speed up the waiting that comes with playing the game. And with how easy it is to adjust, you can find your perfect speed in no time at all.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.